Hello, how are you doing? I hope you're all fine. I want all of you to continue to stay at home, okay, and then make sure you keep safe. We are going to continue our lessons as usual. We are going to continue from where we ended before the lockdown, before we were asked to stay at home. We're going to continue from there. Primary 4, you can bear with me that we finished most of the topics. We are now going to gender of nouns. So if you have forgotten, please, I'm reminding you, we are going to gender of nouns. So let's just take a very quick revision. In Unit 3, we talked about the kinds of nouns, where we talked about common nouns and improper nouns. If you have forgotten what common nouns are, I said that common nouns are just general names that are given to nouns. For example, you can have a school, you can have dog, you can have boy, you can have girl. You know, those ones can be given to just anyone, any school, any town. You understand? Now, the proper nouns are the real names or the actual names that are given to a noun. So let's say take a boy. We can have Kofi as a main name, like the real name of a particular boy. Okay, but the boy is a common noun, but Kofi becomes a proper noun. Let's move on very quick. Now we went to Unit 4 where we talked about the other types of nouns, where we talked about abstract nouns. Some abstract nouns cannot be seen or touched, but we can feel them. For example, like happiness, you can express happiness, but you can't see it. You can express sleep, you can sleep, but you cannot see it, you understand? Those ones are abstract nouns, okay? Then we moved on to collective nouns, like a word, that's a word given to a group of similar things. So if we have, let's say, a group of ladies, you can have a bevy, that's B-E-V-Y, bevy, a bevy of ladies, talk about that already, yes. Now, today, in this lesson, we are going to continue with the other type of noun. Okay, that is gender of nouns. So if you are ready, then let us start. Take your book and open to Unit 6. Unit 6, page 31. So let me take my book and then let's start. Unit 6, page 31, okay? Gender of nouns. Gender of nouns. Now, when you talk about gender, you know, before God created the universe, okay, when God was created the universe, he created a man and he created a woman. Even animals, we have male and we have female. Okay, so we are going to look at the difference between them. How do we call a male dog? How do we call a female dog? That's what you are going to learn. Is that okay? Yes. Now, when we have a man, we have a word that we use to describe him. We say he is masculine. Pronounce it after me. Masculine. Okay. Now, let's go to the female side. We have feminine as female, a woman, a girl. That person is a feminine. Is that okay? Yes. Now let us move on. Now, you know, with this particular topic, I can't give you a list of, like, let's say 100 or even 50 nouns and then they're masculine and they're feminine. You have to go out there, you have to read more, and then you get to identify some of the masculine and the feminine. But with this, we're going to take a look at the book. And then we learn some of them, the ones in the book, okay? Let us take a look at something on page 31. The types of gender. Everything in this world belongs to four different types of gender. In English, belongs to four different types of gender. The first one, as I said, is masculine. That's for the man. Second is feminine. That's for the female. The third one is neuter gender. Neuter gender is for things that are non-living. They do not have life in them. Like a table, like a car, like a bag, like a marker, like a board. These ones are neuter gender. They do not have life in them. So you can't say a word is a male. You can't say a word is a female. Okay? It's just a neuter gender. And then the last one is common gender. With common gender, we give it to whether the thing is a male or female. Because we can give that word to it. That's a gender. Okay? So let's say I am a teacher. If Aunt Dorothy comes to stand here right now, she's also a teacher. Do you understand? So the word teacher can be given to a male or a female. Hope you get me. Yes. Now let us take a look at what's on page 32. There's a table here. Hope you can see it. Yes. Open your book and then look at it. This is mine, so I don't want to share it with you. So open your book to page 32 and look at the table. We have the masculine here, we have the feminine. Boy, please, there should be girl there. You write it. You can put it there. G-I-R-L. Please put it there, okay? Yes. So the feminine for boy is girl. They have put it there for you already. Now look at the second one. Son becomes daughter. If you're not a son, then you're a daughter. That's the female. You understand? Let's take a look at the next one. Father becomes what? Mother. Uncle becomes auntie. Gentleman, lady. Lion becomes lioness. A male lion. Actually, we say a male lion because the lion is only used for male, a male one. And then the lioness is for the female. Okay? So if you are writing an essay and you tell me that the lion gave birth, please, you are wrong. It's the lioness that gave birth. Do you understand me? Yes. That's the main reason why we learn gender of nouns. Let us take a look at the next one. The example of common gender. We have nurse. We have doctor. Please, don't think a doctor is male. No. A male can be a doctor. A female can be a doctor. A man can be a doctor. A woman can also be a doctor. A nurse. Don't think that it's only the girls that can be nurses. Sorry. Okay. A man can also be a nurse. Hope you understand me. Okay, let's move on. A baby. A baby can be a male or female. Okay, so that's a common gender there. Orphan. A student. A pupil. An accountant. A farmer. All these can be a male or female. Okay, now let us go and then write something on the board. Let's take a look at, yes, a teacher can also be a male or female, as I've already said. Let us move on to exercise on page 33. So you have to copy and complete this table, which is in your book already. So what you're supposed to do is that you're going to pause the video, okay? You should just pause the video and then answer the questions. Then I'm going to answer it with you. Please, no cheating. So you just answer it. Just answer it. If you get it correct, I'll tell you. If it's wrong, too, I'll tell you. So just pause the video. I hope you are done. If you're not done, please don't continue this video. If you're not done, don't continue. If you're done, let us answer the questions. So number one, the feminine for father is what? If you wrote mother, you are right, okay? So number one, father is mother. So you must write mother in the space that's provided there. And let's look at number two. Number two is lady. Lady. The masculine for lady is gentleman. Or you can write lord. Lord. L-O-R-D. Lord. You can either write lord or gentleman, okay? Because the feminine for lord is lady. And the feminine for gentleman is also lady. What about uncle? For uncle, I'm sure everybody will get it correct. Because uncle, and then we have auntie. We have princess. What is the masculine for princess? First a princess, then you're a prince. That's the male, okay? Then let us take a look at number five. Hero becomes heroine. I-N-E. Just add I-N-E to it. Hope you're okay. Let us move forward. Man becomes woman, which is very easy. Lord. I've said it in number two. That Lord is lady. That's the feminine. Then let's look at number eight. Hen becomes what? A cock. C-O-C-K. Or a rooster. R-O-O-S-T-E-R. Okay. Either of these. They are all the same. Okay. They are the same. Yes, you can choose any of them and you're right. Gentleman becomes what? Lady. As you said in number two. Then prophet becomes prophetess. The spell of prophetess, just add E-S-S to it. Just add E-S-S to the prophet and you get prophetess. Hope you are okay. Let's move forward. Let's move forward. The next thing I'm going to do right now is that because we have finished answering our question, that was our exercise. We are done. We are going to take a look at more examples. Okay, so that it just don't depend on only the table here, the table on page 32. I'm going to give you more examples. I'm going to write them on the board and then you study them and you learn them. Okay, let's go. So when you take a look at the table here, you can see a list of masculine genders here. You have feminine genders here. As I said, you have other genders. You have the neuter, you have the common. I'll give you examples of those ones, but those ones are very easy. Very easy to memorize. But this is the part that is quite confusing. So let's take a look at this one first. The first one is shepherd. So shepherd, the feminine for shepherd is shepherdess. You add E-S-S to it. So this is the normal one that you need to do. You have to add E-S-S, most of them. You will talk about how to form them. Some of them you have to add just E-S-S, some of them you have to change the spelling totally. Okay. Now this is a dog. Male is the dog, and then the female becomes a bitch. So the bitch will give birth. Does not give birth. Then a bull. A bull and this a cow. Cows give birth. Bulls don't give birth. Take note. Then you have a gander. That's and the goose. That's the female. The male goose is a gander. Okay. That's we have it here. Then king becomes queen. King becomes queen. Then we have sir, madam, sir, madam. So I am a sir. I am a sir. Antipetual is madam. Ankobi is a sir. Ankedem is a sir. And Antibarakisu is a madam. We have nephew. Nephew becomes niece. Nephew is male. Niece is female. Landlord becomes landlady. Don't call everyone landlord. If the person is a male, we call the person a landlord. If the person is a female, we call the person a landlady. Then we have a Drake becomes duck. Drake and then not duck. Poet becomes poetess. Someone who writes poems is a poet. Then the female becomes poetess. This is a male. Now you have tiger becomes tigress, and then master becomes mistress. Master becomes mistress. So you have a head master. We have head mistress. Head master is the male, head mistress is the female. Hope you understand this particular lesson. What you're going to do is you're going to have a homework. When I give you the assignment, what you do is that after answering them, you take a picture like what you always do. You take a picture of it with your phone, then you send it to them through WhatsApp. Hope you understand. Yeah. So let's take our books. Let's go back to our books. And open to page 33. Very quick, okay? 33. Exercise C. Exercise C. You have to use the right gender nouns in bracket to complete the sentences. The questions are 1 to 5. Answer all of them. Which is very simple. Answer all of them. Okay? When you finish, as I said, make sure you take a picture of it and then you send it to Uncle through WhatsApp. Thank you very much.